You look so pretty. Wish he could play.
I wish he could.
Thank you.
sure?
I'm a lot of us here.
This show is really well rehearsed, folks. We know everything we're doing next.
Thank you.
afternoon. Well, my name is Pam Setser, for you that don't know me. And some of you know me all the way back to when I was Simmons. And we all had, well, I didn't have any gray hair. And y'all do, but I cover mine up, so. We're glad that all of you came, and we are here to celebrate two men that have given 42 years to the Arkansas State Parks and Tourism. And I'd like to ask Richard Davies and Greg Butts to stand up so that we can clap for them and recognize them. And personally, I'm very honored to be a part of this today because I've known these guys for probably 42 years. And so, not only have I known them connected to the Folk Center, but they're friends of mine, and so I'm very proud to be part of this. And I do want to recognize we have some other folks here that are very special to us, too. And so I want to just announce you as groups, and so if you'll stand up, if you're part of the Folk Cultural Commission, if you'll please stand. We appreciate you very much. Now that we have any Arkansas State Parks and Tourism staff, you'll stand. And any present and former Ozark Folk Center staff, if you would stand. And I know we have my dad, Tony Simmons, who is first manager. Don't stand with me. Appreciate all of you being here. And now, a very special group, the Committee of 100. If you are a Committee of 100 member, would you please stand? Now, if you are a past chairman, would you please stand back up? And these ladies, the past chairman, are our host for this reception today, honoring you guys, and we appreciate them very much. They knew there would be a lot of formal occasions for your retirement parties, and so we wanted to do something that was just a taste of Mountain View. So we hope you enjoy this. We're going to do a little picking.
Now we have the pickers.
Change hands.
Change hands. This is an old fiddle tune that the Blair family played this, and I actually learned it from Kay and Bob years ago. Everything's years ago.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Thank you.
And I hope you join us. Now we're going to do one. This was written by a lady who lived over around Fox, Arkansas, which several of you know where Fox, Arkansas is. And I always have to tell this story because several of you are, well, old enough to remember this, I know. Her name was Fanny Clark, and she was from Fox. And one night I got mixed up, and I said it was written by Fanny Fox. Y'all remember who Fanny Fox was? So I'm very careful. It's written by Fanny Clark, and it's a beautiful song called Bluebird.
Hold the whip pile down. Everything's wrong. Nothing is right. Hold the whip pile down. Gave him the Hollywood Pollyanna, folks don't know how bad I am. Hollywood Pollyanna, took it home and I laid it on the shelf. Hollywood Pollyanna, I was so bad I scared myself. Hollywood Pollyanna, I was traveling, as long as the world goes round. Back to our shine on the Georgia line. Hollywood
Charley Sandage. Charley was actually the first music director here at the Ozark Folk Center, and he's got something that we're going to share.
Is that not right?
Mm-hmm.
I thought that, I mean,
that's it.
It's kind of blurry for me to see that, but I thought it was correct.
Get all the cheers back here.
Thank you.
It's too small for me to read way down there.
Is this, as I'll explain, this is all done by stealth. We're pleased to announce the establishment by the Committee of 100 of the annual Richard Davies Memorial Lecture on Arcane Aspects of Ozark Balladry. We were asked to keep this all entirely secret until this moment, and we must say we are honored to be selected to deliver this inaugural installment. We'll talk about the way in which certain themes have always run through not a single ballad, but through many, how these themes have often been about royalty, kings, princes, ladies, and such. One example is the way many Scottish tunes from our British Isles musical heritage refer to Charley, as in Charley Over the Ocean or Charley He's a Good Old Boy. Diverse as these lyrics were, they were always referring to Bonnie Prince Charley of Scotland. Another aspect we want to develop, you're taking notes, Brooks, is variation. A verse might have read one way in the Midlands of England, but another in the Appalachian region of America, yet another here in the Ozarks. There might be even another variation in a local area, such as here in Stone County. We'll start with an example of that. One song that has been sung here at the Ozark Folk Center is titled Blackjack Davy. It is quite long, tells a complicated story about the adventures of a rogue who bedevils the lord of the realm with his scandalous behavior, and it starts like this.
Blackjack Davy came a-riding through the hills, sang so loud and gaily, made the woods around him ring, and he charmed the heart of a lady, he charmed the heart of a lady.
Here around the Folk Center, our version not only changes names and characters, but the story is scattered throughout various different ballads. It isn't some young rogue who sings, but all the inhabitants of a certain remote outpost in the mountainous part of the realm where a young lord is on the verge of taking charge. And it is the young lord who is charmed and deceived by their music. That outpost, by the way, has often been referred to in this collection, is referred to in this collection as the Hill.
Young Lord Davies came a-riding to the hill where they sang so loud and gaily, made the woods around them ring, and they charmed the heart of young Davies. They charmed the heart of young Davies.
Being young and naive, the young lord thinks, of all my realm, the hill will be a place of music and merriment, and it will be a retreat when I need to escape the trouble and drudgery of the rest of my realm. But he had hardly been installed as ruler of the realm when a squabble developed on the hill. And one faction plotting against the other said,
oh, let's go down to the city to say, You've just got to see it our way. And who will wear the story crown? Young Lord, you got to see it our way. Oh, brothers, let's go down. Come on down, we got to go down. Oh, brothers, let's go down. Gonna make him see it our way.
Young Lord Davies learned very early that the hill was to be constantly plagued by problems. The subjects were unruly. They made incessant demands. Their revenues were never adequate. And messengers constantly came to the young Lord saying,
all the good times are past and gone. All the good times are gone. All the good times are past and gone. Read the numbers and weep some more.
Time after time, the young Lord would send one of his minions to oversee matters on the hill and to find a solution to the outpost's constant problems.
Children, go, how I send thee? How shall I send thee? Oh, I'm going to send thee one by one. Send the one who will get it done. Get them in line,
in line,
in line, in line up on the hill.
Sometimes he would send both a new overseer and an assistant overseer.
Children, go, how I send thee? How shall I send thee? Oh, I'm going to send thee two by two. Do whatever you need to do. Get in line,
in line, in line,
in line up on the hill.
In desperation, the by now not so young Lord Davies would sometimes throw up his hands, saying,
children, go, how I send thee? How shall I send thee? Oh, do I have to send thee three by three? That hill's gonna be the death of me. Can't get them in line,
in line, in line,
in line up on the hill.
Sometimes the supervising minion of the Lord of the Realm had sent to the hill would come riding back to the city, saying,
I've played around and stayed around this old hill too long. Everything I try just keeps going wrong. If I stay around much longer, my career will be long gone. And I feel like I've got to travel on.
At one point, the Lord of the Realm thought, what the hill needs is some noble ladies to go among them. Show them how to conduct their affairs in a genteel and pleasing way. Perhaps even teach them how to solve their constant money problems. So he gathered a great number of ladies from the realm, saying,
come all ye fair and kindred ladies, take warning how they court their friends. They want support and lots of money, and their demands will never end.
Another time, the Lord of the Realm came up with an excessively bright solution.
Come go with me, Lord Davies said, off in a new direction. If we get lost, we can always make another course correction. Another course correction.
Didn't work anywhere in the realm, and certainly not on the hill. Sometimes, the only solace the Lord of the Realm could find was in pouring out the tale of his woes to his own fair lady. It is not recorded how the lady responded to these tales of misery.
Do you remember sweet Betsy from Georgia? She had to put up with much more than she ordered. When news from the hill would cause Lord Davies grief, there'd be wailing and mourning and gnashing of teeth.
Finally, as the Lord of the Realm began to approach a doddering old age, he began to be philosophical about the people of the hill. On one occasion, very much like this occasion, he said to them, "The time draws near, my dearest dears, when you and I must part. How little you know of the grief and woe in my poor and aching heart. In fact, upon reflection, dears, my grief is very small. I'm going away to a secret place, and I'm not telling y'all." The thread seems to end with this verse of our saga, but our research into Ozark Folk Center balladry continues. Perhaps new revelations will yet appear. Thank you.
We won't have something to present to you. And you will be getting a video of all this.
Inside our cast.
No, yes.
Thank you, Charley.
The new Arkansas State song.
Yes. Did Charley Sandage not do a great job on that?
I learned this from Bob Blair. Well, I went out to a big crap game. It was against my will. I bet all of my money except one greenback dollar bill. There was $100 on the table. Feelings, they were high. Just then a cop came through the door and I got mine. Well, I got mine, boys. I got mine. Well, I grabbed that $100 for the window I did climb. For a while I wasn't wearing good clothes, living on chicken and wine. I was a leader in society when I got mine. Then I went out to a big cafe, I went in there to dine. Well, I only had 15 cents, was full of good white wine. I ate everything on the table and was feeling mighty fine. Till I handed over that 15 cents and I got mine. Well, I got mine, boys. I got mine. They used me for football. At the kick-in, they was fine. They kicked me through the window. Well, I got there just in time. A policeman took me to the judge and I got mine. Then I went to get some chicken. You know, the night was very fine. Well, I found them roosting mighty high and for them I did climb. A bulldog came prowling round, he got there just in time. When he caught me by the seat of my pants, then he got mine, yeah, he did. Well, he got mine, boys, he got mine. Well, some other yeah. I can't even that rascal took my riches, yeah, he did it very fine. I went home in a barrel. Well, I got there just in time. And I used some Dr. Brown, say where he got mine. Yeah, I used some Dr. Brown, say where he got mine. I heard a professional musician say one time, if you've never missed the words of the song, you haven't sang it enough.
Stand up, but it'll take too long to read just the back. Whoa, death come knocking at that sinner's door. Said, "Oh, Center, are you ready to go?" He said,
"No, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no. Ain't got on my traveling shoes. Do some singing,
no, no, no,
all of
no, no, no.
Ain't got on my traveling
shoes.
Whoa, death come knocking at that gambler's door. Said, "Oh, gambler, are you ready to go?" He said,
"No, no, no,
Lordy,
no, no, no.
Ain't got on my traveling shoes. Do some singing,
no, no, no.
Oh, no, 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 ain't got on my traveling shoes. Whoa, death come knocking at that liar's door. Said, "Oh, liar, are you ready to go?" He said,
"Yes, no, no,
Lord, no,
no, no,
ain't got on my traveling shoes. Do some singing,
no, no, no,
oh, Lord,
no, no, no.
Ain't got on my traveling
shoes.
Whoa, death come knocking at that Christian's door. Said, "Oh, Christian, are you ready to go?" He said,
"Yes, yes, yes,
Lordy,
yes, yes, yes.
Just put on my traveling
shoes.
Just do some singing.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, Lordy,
yes, 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 yes.
Just put on my traveling shoes."
I think they wanted me to play something else to kind of, this is the part where I play and they run out to get cookies and
things. Not yet.
Okay, well, you have stuff with your milk.
All right. This is another fast one, so if you want to get up and jig dance, help yourself, guys. Y'all can be the leaders.
Here we go.
All right, John, let's go.
Kiss a girl, soon you'll have to marry.
Fly around my pretty little miss, fly around my daisy. Fly around my pretty little miss, you almost drive me crazy.
Greg, he's a good old guy. Greg, he's a dandy. Greg, he's a good old guy, feeds him girls no candy.
Fly around my pretty little miss, fly around my daisy. Fly around my pretty little miss, you almost drive me crazy.
Until just about a week ago, that he was retiring. So he might have done that on purpose because he wasn't sure what we would do. But we appreciate Greg. We have a committee of 100 cookbook, and was he ever a help with selling that? Because he politely told all the state parks to sell them. So it worked great. It really boosted our sales. And so we appreciate him so much. And we do have a little gift for you, though. We've heard that every time he comes to the Folk Center, he always gets him a jar of chunky, peach chunky or apple chunky. So we have you two cases. So here's one, and there's another one back here before you leave. So appreciate Greg Butts very much. Thank you. Back over here, we're going to do a song that Charley Sandage wrote that's very appropriate for this occasion because we're all neighbors and friends, and that's what this song is about. And if you know it, sing along. And if you don't, please don't.
And that kind of thing never stopped us.
I do right over here my little pick, candy dandy pick.
I like to say it's really nice to be able to participate in this and not fear being fired.
I hate to admit it, he goes, are we four of the oldest musicians here? And I said, well, I hate to admit it, but I have played at the Folk Center since it opened in 73.
Me too.
So, long time.
Yeah.
And we hadn't changed a bit. So I know about all those happenings on the hill. Yes. Choose your friends for their powers, their love, or their gold. It seems like a sign of the times, but some folks remember what neighbors are for, and some of them are neighbors of mine. I have lived among some good and gentle people. I have walked a strong rolling land. This is not goodbye because we want you to come to the Folk Center and see us a lot. But we love you and appreciate all that you've done for us over the years, both of you. We do have some whatever out there, something to eat. Refreshments, that's the word I was looking for. Refreshments we do have out there that these ladies have baked. And so we want you to go out and visit with these guys and enjoy. We love you and we hope you have a wonderful retirement.
Yeah.